Babysitter Girls, welcome back to Babysitter Guru channel. I'm so guys glad that you guys are here with me today. So today we're going to discuss exactly what to wear while babysitting. This is a popular topic that I'm always asked about, and I can't wait to dive in even further with you. Let's get started. Okay, so I'm gonna first address exactly what I wear while babysitting. It's a bit embarrassing, but that's something, you know, I choose to kind of take in. Let's just say the feedback on. Okay, so while babysitting, it's important to wear comfortable clothing, extremely stretchable clothing as well when you guys are babysitting. That's just something that I prefer, because just keep in mind, you guys are running around after the kids, and depending on the age, you don't know exactly what you're gonna be doing with them. Are they gonna be outside, taking them out for a stroll, inside, you know, running up and down, changing their diapers, or catching them while they're running around. So it definitely depends and it varies. So, I'll tell you guys exactly what I wear while babysitting. I specifically only buy activewear clothing to go babysit, guys. So no shame in my game, but that's exactly what I buy to go babysitting. And I don't even work out, unfortunately. So no judgment zone, please, but that's exactly why I buy activewear clothing. My yoga pants and my cotton t-shirt are my number one go-tos for babysitting, basically. So those are my two pieces of clothing that I have on all the time when I go babysit with the babies. So that's something I like to wear. I like to feel comfortable. In addition to that, I have either my slippers or my slip-on sneakers. I am obsessed with slip-on sneakers. Slip-on sneakers are my go-to shoes to wear, because if I have to run out anywhere with their children, I can just easily slip them on instead of having to, you know, figure out how to tie them step by step. I'm sure you guys remember when you started to learn exactly how to tie your shoes, then do like the two little bunnies. So I don't feel like doing that. So I just literally have slip-on sneakers just for that. Or slippers. I love slippers. Slippers in the summertime and the springtime are my go-tos as well, in addition to socks. So the one thing I would admit, when I do babysit in the household, when I am in the household, I wear socks. I always bring an extra pair of socks. For some reason, I do not like when my feet touch the floor. I'm really anti like that. So I always have an extra pair of socks with me. But slippers, whenever we're outside, I'll wear them with the children. In addition to that, jewelry, guys, please, please, please do not wear jewelry that hangs. Anything that looks flashy, the kids are gonna want to pull, because it looks nice, it looks appealing to them, and that will catch their eye the first thing that they see. So anything with like watches or bracelets or anything that dangles, or even earrings that dangle, do not wear, because they're gonna pull on them, especially if you don't want them to break. You know, obviously they're not doing it on purpose, it's just something that catches their attention, and whatever catches their attention, they're gonna want to touch. So please, please, please do not wear that. Literally, I have on our little studs. This is exactly what I wear when I go babysit. I barely wear any jewelry, so it's just little earrings. So this really doesn't catch their attention at all, especially depending on how your hair is. And as you know, I have box braids on, so it's usually always covered, so they don't even see it. So please be cautious exactly what jewelry to wear. In addition to that, please be comfortable, comfortable, comfortable. Do not wear your expensive name brand clothing when you go babysit. That's something you do not want to do, because once it gets stained, it's a done deal, especially if it's a stain that can't come out. So please, please, please do not wear expensive clothing. Please be prepared. However, fair warning, I'm gonna let you guys know right now, you might get peed on. That happened to me at least 5 times during my duration of babysitting. I've been peed on, and believe it or not, every time it happens, I'm always like, oh, did the baby just pee on me? And then I start laughing, and then they start laughing as well, because they know they just peed on me. So that's something that's really cute, but at the same time, you don't want that to happen often. So if the baby happens to pee on you, please have on a top that, you know, it's okay to have pee on it, because you can always go home and put it in the washer. It also, it goes the same thing with food. So sometimes kids have food where like they have like the applesauce or like the baby food that's mixed with vegetables or any type of fruits that could also cause stains on your clothing. So be prepared for that, which is why I highly suggest do not wear any type of expensive brand clothing that you're not willing to get it dirty just a little bit. Or even if you're outside and you're playing with like the dirt or something, or like they're planting anything with the grass, be prepared for it to have like a little dirt on it. So just be cautious of what you wear. You definitely don't want to go babysitting and seeing the kids and spending time with them with clothing that you're not comfortable with having on. So those are my top two, actually three things that I suggest you guys wear when babysitting. That's always my go-to. That's strictly been my go-to when I go babysit. Also with bags. So when you guys have bags, I preferably have tote bags whenever I go babysit. I just literally throw anything and everything in there. Tote bags I usually got from like a thrift store. I just, you know, carry all my stuff in. Usually the bags, they won't touch if you put it in a certain area. So you should be good on that. In terms of hair, so currently I have box braids on, so they're very fascinated with the box braids. They love to look at it, pull at it, and just like touch it because it's so long, as you guys could see how long the box braids are. So I suggest you have it on like a bun, your hair. As you can see, I actually changed my hair, guys. So in my picture, my bun was a bit different. It was a bit too high, so I kind of want to, like, you know, a little lower it down a little bit for you. But the hair, I always suggest putting it up so that they won't be able to grab it. If you have long hair, as my box braids, as you can see, they will pull on it. So I try not to have it out as much, or I will put it in a braid, like a big braid, and then tie the end of it. Okay, guys, so thank you so much for joining me today. Definitely stay tuned for our next episode with an even interestingmore topic. So thank you so much, gurus. Have a great day and love you guys. Bye, gurus.